prayer of thanksgiving for our founder. We give thanks to thee, O God, for the wisdom and charity which moved Claude Martin, our founder, to establish these schools, for the manifold blessings that thou hast vouchsafed to these schools since that time, and for the devoted service of those who have taught and served and who now teach and serve in them, for the happy comradeship and abiding friendships that have flourished here, for those who have gone forth from here into the world to serve thee, and for those who are now here, for all the memories of the past which ennoble and enrich the present. Amen. A prayer for Founders Day. Bless, O Lord, these colleges and use them in all things according to thy will. May thy presence be ever within their walls. May they stand always for all that is true and noble. Grant that we and others may so gain from their life that many may bless thee for the day that they were founded, and that their work may be extended and continued for the generations yet to come. Amen.
A prayer for La Martiniere schools in Lyon, Kolkata and Lucknow. O God, make these thy schools in Lyon, Kolkata and Lucknow as fields which thou hast blessed, that whatsoever things are true, pure, lovely and of good report may in these schools forever flourish and abound. Preserve in them an unblemished name, enlarge in them with a wider usefulness, and exalt them in the love and reverence of all their members as instruments of thy glory. Amen.
A prayer for all Martinians. O God, our Father, we beseech thee to shield with the protection of thine everlasting love all those who in the days past have studied in these schools, and we humbly pray that by thy grace they may ever so order their lives as to be worthy of their heritage in the fellowship of this foundation and in the wider brotherhood of all those who love and fear thy name. Amen.
Oh. first displayed. Blessed is my soul, my Savior to me.
Greetings of the day and hearty congratulations on our 185th Founders Day. My good wishes to all our pupils and their families. It's been a very unusual and trying year for all of us. We miss you all and also your activities. However, thanks to this digital technology that we can connect virtually and also celebrate and observe our Founders Day on this virtual platform. I have a message for my pupils this morning, and I would like you all to ponder and consider two of the many virtues that our founder, Major General Claude Martin, had. The first being generosity. Our founder was generous. And to the little ones and the very young Martinians, let me explain what generosity is. Imagine you are in school, and just when the bell rings for the break time, you go down and you find another boy, maybe not your friend and from your own class, sitting all alone and without his tiffin. And you go and ask him, and he tells you that he's forgotten his tiffin box. So you decide to share your tiffin. Once you open your tiffin box, what do you find? Your favorite snack. Pizza. But just one wedge. That is one piece. So you are tempted not to share. But then you remember that you've been taught by your school and your parents to share. So you break that one piece into two and give it to this boy who's not even known to you. So generosity is when you give to others without expecting anything in return. The second virtue is visionary. Our founder had a foresight. So a person who can see so that something can be done for a better tomorrow. That means we can invest our potentials, our talents, what we have today, to make a better tomorrow. I read somewhere, someone asked Helen Keller, what is worse than being blind? And her reply was that a person who can see and has no vision. So to all the Martinians, this is my urge that you all need to be generous and secondly, to be visionaries. Once again, wishing you a very happy Founders Day. God bless each one of you. Thank you.
In 1752, a 17-year-old Frenchman came to India as a mere ensign for the French East India Company. Through his determination and hard work, Claude Martin steadily rose in rank, and by the time he died, he was a major general in the ranks of the English East India Company, and was able to leave behind a handsome fortune that was used to establish several educational institutions in two countries.
Born in Lyon on 4th January 1735, Claude Martin attended a local parish school where he excelled in mathematics and physics. At the age of 14, Martin was apprenticed to a silk manufacturer to learn the trade. However, a true adventurer at heart, he had other plans. He signed up with the French East India Company, much against the wishes of his stepmother, who in tears gave him a purse of 24 coins, boxed his ears and said, "Go, you obstinate one, but don't ever come back unless you are in a carriage." Unfortunately, later, Martin could not return to Lyon in a carriage, owing to the French Revolution, which had already begun.
In India, Martin did not restrict himself to the military profession. He tried his hand at many things. He was a polymath in the truest sense. He had deep knowledge regarding a wide range of subjects. He made himself quite indispensable to the East India Company as a surveyor. His surveys were of paramount importance as they helped in extending British knowledge of Northeast India. This is exactly how he reached Oudh, or modern-day Lucknow. He was instructed by the company to conduct a survey of Oudh.
When he went to serve Asafuddaulah, the Nawab of Oudh, he got a chance to display his multiple talents. He designed cannons and ammunition for the Nawab, as well as served as an architect of several buildings which bear proud testimony to this skill. In fact, the Raj Bhavan, where the governor of Uttar Pradesh lives today, was designed by Claude Martin himself. And this was where he breathed his last. Constantia, which currently houses La Martiniere College, Lucknow, was the home of Claude Martin, an astounding edifice that speaks volumes about a man who lived life king size and whose generosity was sans bound.
He was a hot air ballooning enthusiast, and he is believed to have introduced Asaduddaulah to this port. Alan Seeley documents this in his novel, Shotarnama. He patronized several famous artists of the time, notably Zoffany and Rinaldi.
It is believed that at the time of his death, he had a library comprising 4,000 volumes written in several languages.
The Martiniere coat of arms. This was designed by Major General Claude Martin himself. It is supported by 7 flags, each bearing the design of a fish, the emblem of Oudh. These flags represent his journey over the 7 seas to India. The devices on the escutcheon, or the shield, epitomize Claude Martin's career. The ship recalls his voyage to India where, center of the shield, he firmly established his fortunes in Oudh as an officer of the East India Company. This is represented by the lion with the pennant. The setting sun behind the castellated building on the right of the shield indicates the sunset of his days and the important part which the building of Constantia played in his twilight years. Major General Claude Martin died on 13th September 1800 and was laid to rest in a tomb that he himself designed. In his will, he desired that this day be marked with a solemn service in his memory and a dinner hosted for pupils. A toast is raised in silence in memory of the founder.
Of all the European adventurers who sought and built fortunes in India, Claude Martin alone enjoys the distinction of leaving the greater part of his wealth to diverse charitable causes. He realized the value of education as he was a self-taught man. Martin wrote, "I have read a lot, pen in hand, often under difficult conditions, and I know the value of the first rudiments inculcated by the parson at St. Saturnin. That is why I divide my fortune in two. I want to thank all those who have been around me by making their lives easier after my death. I also want to give the children of both Lyon and India the instruction I received with so much difficulty. I want to make it easy for young people to get access to knowledge, especially the sciences."
He left vast endowments to set up schools in Calcutta, Lucknow, and Lyon. He wrote, "I give and bequeath the sum of 200,000 Sikka rupees to the town of Calcutta, that they may devise an institution the most necessary for the public good of the town of Calcutta, for establishing a school to educate a certain number of children of any sex to a certain age."
Thus began the La Martiniere saga. Thousands of students have passed through these portals and are proud bearers of his name and legacy, ever grateful for the foresight and generosity of our founder, Major General Claude Martin. O Almighty God and Most Merciful Father, who has taught us to praise Thee as well for the dead as the living, we thank Thee for Claude Martin, our founder, for Catchick Paul Chater, our benefactor, and for the lives and examples of all who have served Thee in this school. Pour down Thy blessing, we pray Thee, upon those who are now here. Prosper our labors as Thou in Thy wisdom seest to be best for us. Protect us, we beseech Thee, from all things hurtful, both to soul and body. Preserve us by Thy Holy Spirit from sin and selfishness, and make us generous and brave, pure and true, in all our work and in all our play, that our tasks being sanctified by Thy love, our days here may be attended by Thy blessing, and that, when our day's work on earth is over, Thou mayest send us rest from our labors under the shadow of Thy wing, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.